and have allowed me to do all of the marketing for Roger and his event in Australia whilst living here in Bali. So to give you an example, the Fast Forward Your Business events, the last two Fast Forward Your Business events, I was not in Australia at all to actually set up those promotions, have the marketing go out, book the events, have the speakers that showed up on the stage in the forum at Roger Durandi runs a 1 hour forum with a number of change makers that we identify. We were able to organize all those people and have 1,000 odd people show up each time for the event. How am I able to do that from Bali without having resources and potentially having to do it all and be there, which I thought I needed to do prior to that, because all of the other events I'd always run, I was always there, connecting with people and phoning them and meeting up with them and that type of thing. But when you actually take it from perspective that you actually can do all of that from anywhere, then these are some of the ways that I've done that. So the first system I'm going to show you is actually up in our when we looked at the multifunctional systems, but I'll show you inside of this the difference between a one-dimensional system to a multi-dimensional system. So Platform Direct was built around my own need for marketing. So the things that I considered really important when doing any marketing was, number one, being able to get effective communication out, but then being able to report on that and being able to then be quite specifically about the people that I'm talking to based on either their interactivity with me or their interactivity with the marketing that I'm doing. So either a physical showing up at an event or buying a product or whatever it might be. So a mechanism that I could record all that and then be able to analyze the information and then send specific information based on that. So if they bought a certain product at a certain event, then be able to put out a specific marketing piece that talks about that or continues that conversation. Make sense? Yep. So what you'll get from a very singular type program like a Constant Contact or something like that, is that it'll have an email marketing system where you can basically go in there and build email marketing. So you can write the email. So I'll just pull up anyone, doesn't really matter. Let's pull up something like, I'll just see what we've got here. So, pull up something like this one here. So an email here has gone out. That's the email there. And this is for Green Supercamp, because I also run all the marketing for Green Supercamp for Roger as well. So here's a piece of marketing that was created that goes out. And this one here is one of 12 scholarships worth over $20,000 to the Green Supercamp in Bali. So that's the subject of the email. Very simple email, got a video in it and stuff like that, and got some links. Yep. Everyone knows how you can do that. Anyone built run an email campaign where they've actually emailed out? Anyone not? Yeah. So a few of us. So this is the really simple thing here is I build these in Microsoft Word. So I'll just write out the content that I want, and I just drop in basic images. So that there is just an image. I just took a screenshot of the video. And I dropped that in, and I gave that to my content team that actually puts the content into the email marketing system, and told them where the links needed to go and stuff. I didn't need to know anything about HTML, anything else. I write the content out, or if you don't want to write the content, give it to a content writer and just give them some guidelines of what the outcome of the email you're looking for. And it could be as simple as, I want to run a competition. It's for the Green Supercamp. Here's all of the media that I have about that. Here's the website, et cetera, et cetera. It's going to be a scholarship. It's going to be this. It's going to be that. And my intention is for people to register for that for competition and to apply for that scholarship. Yeah? So I could give them that brief and they could write it for me. And that way you don't have to even know how to write response marketing, which is also a, there's a big difference also between response marketing versus a copywriter. And I say copywriter, marketing copywriters are very good at writing copyright, which sounds good, which is you know, filled with benefits and you know, reads well. Where response marketers, the content actually may not even seem like it reads well. If you're very fluent in English, you may look at some of the response marketing content and go, well, what are the, you know, the languaging is not, it's not, you know, grammatically correct and stuff like that. But there's reason, as you would know, why they do that, is about actually creating flow and creating response actions from the person that they're talking to. They may, you know, formatting wise, they'll do it in different ways as well. So when doing that type of thing, make sure the person that you're talking to is depending on what you're looking for, is either a response marketing copywriter or a marketing copywriter. So that's the email. The thing that you'll get from almost every single one of them today, I'm sure you'll get from all of them, is the actual results of that campaign. So, you know, what was the result of it? So over here, went out to 4,493 people, 98.9% delivery rate. So it means that a few people obviously didn't get that. Emails opened was 38.4%, 1,751 people opened that. And out of that, we had 32 click-throughs, which had 27 unique people who actually went and registered for the competition. So in an email like that, what I'd be looking to do is, again, either tweak the people that it went out to or tweak the actual content itself, because that, you know, the actual click-throughs and registrations were quite low. But obviously, I got to the right people with the subject line, yep. Because that's a very high rate of open rate. So something like that would be typically, if you had said a base system, that's all it would do. It would be able to, you know, have some contacts, write a campaign, email out and get some statistics. That makes sense? So that's a single dimension marketing system. A system like this, I actually then look at that email again, it says over here, click this, complete this entry form over here, and then that's a form that's been built up where they actually then go and actually write in the reason why they would like their child or somebody else's child actually be part. So that one there is a form that's actually built inside of the system as well. Many systems will have subscription forms that you can then utilize inside of your website. So what you're wanting to do systematically whenever you're doing anything like a website or a landing page or whatever else, you want all your contacts come into one central location. So whenever you build a website, might be in WordPress or you know, Drupal or whatever else system that you might be using, there's a whole bunch of different brands and types of web systems that are out there. You want to get your email marketing system or your membership management system to collect all of that data in one place. Does that make sense? So all of your systems should be able to build you some level of subscription form that you can then place inside of your website. And they use terminology called iframes or whatever it might be to actually place that in. So for instance, in this system here, you can build web forms, and I'll just take the registration, Green Supercamp Bali. Supercamp competition registration, that probably looks like it there. So this one here, this is the form that was built in inside of here, which is to actually receive all of the information about whoever's registering. And that you can create whatever types of forms inside of this one. You can create fields which are custom fields as well against each person. So pretty much all the way from as simple as here's the different fields that they need to create, and you drag that in from the fields. You put some form options, which are, you know, what does it look like, header, footer, and whatever else, all the way to the email option. So what happens when the email, they fill that out, then this is the email that goes back to the user. You know, do you want to verify their email account, all that type of thing. So this system would takes building forms to probably a whole different level to what you'd get in the basic systems. But you know, this all helps when it comes to you then being able to build more effective campaigns, and also make sure that the people that are registering are double opt-in and stuff like that, which I'll talk with you about in another session. So address book-wise, a big difference between a product like this versus your single dimension, again, is around actually searching and segmenting your contacts. So if you had a constant contact or an AWeber, you know, generally your kind of search would be on their name, their first name, their last name, and what group they might be in. When you go for more advanced systems, you can then actually build up your search conditions. So you can start building in anything around, you know, does it contain this name, or if we have to say something like group. So let's say, I don't know, MyHQ, which was one of our businesses that we ran there. Are they in that group or are they not in that group? Whatever else. So you can actually start building a search criteria which is based on and, or not, and then get a list of people based on a very, very specific criteria that you might be wanting to target. Yeah? So this is about really getting clear on who you're targeting when you're sending your email out. And then let's just talk to those people. Let's talk to the people who are interested in that already. We might have a higher level invite that goes out to, you know, the greater database that invites more people in over time. But when you're speaking like specifically about kids, that one there you would have seen went to 4,400 people. The reason why it went out to 4,400 people, because the year before when we did the marketing, those were the 4,400 people who opened up the emails prior that year. So I only sent that next marketing piece out to those same people because I knew that at some level they were interested. As well, inside of that were people who had clicked through and registered and that type of thing, and I actually then sent quite specific email marketing to the people who had registered before to get them to re-register this year. So you can build up very, very advanced search conditions and criteria to get very specific result and a specific list of people that you want to talk to. And of course, the whole thing here is about being able to have, you know, quite specific information about those people. So you can really start segmenting that by creating, you know, fields and groups of fields that are specific about how they're interacting with you. So you'll just see, for instance, over here, I have quite a lot of things broken down into what they're interested in. So, you know, so their basic member information. This is all around if they're interested in property and investment. There's if they're an affiliate and what kind of affiliate. This was around our mentoring stuff as well. Are we mentoring them in investment or in business? What webinars and events have they come to? All that type of thing. I break all that down specific to certain events based on their interaction with me. So where can you take it further from that? Then, you know, you can then go out in the multi-dimension one is actually go and build splash pages. So again, this is all in one place, in one space, to be able to actually do all that. I don't know, you can just take anything really, whatever that one's opening up. So this is a marketing piece that we did with a guy named Harry Charalambos, good friend of ours. In Sydney, who runs an investment property business. So that's a landing page for him, you know, some testimonials and stuff like that. And all of the stuff that people can do to actually come to his event, they can click here to book now. And again, it's all integrated. On this one here, we actually ran off Eventbrite because they wanted to be able to manage a whole bunch of different affiliates through Eventbrite. So the difference here really was, and in this system here, it doesn't actually have affiliate management. So we actually needed to use an external program to actually manage the affiliates. So that kind of, does that give you like a sense of the kinds of things that you can expect in one system versus like really basic, just your email and your list? Yeah? Yeah, this one has SMS as well. So there's the SMS marketing as well. So I can go into that and I can run any SMS campaign. So let's just create an SMS campaign. What's the name of the campaign? Let's just leave that right there. You can all of this type of thing you obviously set, you preset dates, so you can do all planning. So so for like SMSs, when you actually you build your event, you'd set up your SMS reminders to go out, you know, maybe a day before. I specifically send out one day before, and I send out 1 hour before with the exact directions on how to get there and where to park and stuff like that. So people are coming along, they're in their car, they're going, oh, shoot, where do I go again? Bang, in comes the SMS. No, you're on your way. Here are the directions, and here's a phone number to call somebody if you need some help. So I have that all preset, the time exactly where it's going to go and that type of thing. So you want to be able to do this so you can plan all of your campaigns. So as simple as this, sorry, we want to sit. Yeah, that's right. So all of this, all of the systems are here to do that. But when, like anything, there's pricing associated to usage. So this one's main base price is based on how many emails you send every single month, not the amount of members or how much access you have. And then additional things like an SMS marketing. Once we've written our SMS here, and I can put in, you know, their specific name, that'll come bring that. So something like that. You can have automatic unsubscribes from that as well, that you can write in how to opt out and stuff like that. We're not going to do that. But yeah, ignore. And then it will actually give me the pricing based on, once I actually choose how many people that's going to go out to, it'll tell me, well, it's going to cost you so much to send this out. And you can buy forward credit and stuff like that. So let's just take a group of, I know, 7 people over there. Add them to my recipient list. And then, yeah, it comes up and says, that's going to cost me 85 cents to send it to those people. And if I already have that inside of my pre-purchased, it's like Skype credits and whatever else. I've got that in my credit already, then I will just send it out. Yep. So just grab that then.
I've always used MessageNet with my SMS because what I found, the older clients that I deal with that aren't connected on the internet, so all it's, you know, it's a foreign body to them. And so I collect mobile numbers as well, but I have, you know, nearly 300 women on SMS, and that then sort of racks up quite a lot.
Yeah.
You know, I think MessageNet is 22 cents.
Yeah, gotcha.
An SMS.
Well, it depends on your promotion. So, whenever you run any promotion, you're going to have certain financial outcome, and it might be part of a, you know, there might be a number of different projects inside of that promotion that actually gives you a financial outcome. So each event might lead to, you know, your final outcome. However, your final outcome is a financial outcome. So as long as you know what that is and you've already predetermined what that value of that is, you know, building or working out your costs and associating that, that's then much simpler. And then it doesn't become an issue going, oh, you know, I've just spent another, you know, $200 here because I've had to SMS, because I know what my outcomes going to look like.
Yeah. And can in SMS, can you break it down to SMS just the people that, like in systems like these, like target age brackets?
Yeah, exactly.
You know.
Yeah, exactly. So when you saw me do that customized search, I can go down to age brackets or whatever.
With the select.
Yeah, I can bring it right down and just get just that list of people that I want to talk to. And then when I selected the group of people there, that would be the group of people I then send it to.
Well, like, yeah, with my short jumpsuits, I wouldn't be sending them to my SMS girls who are 60 plus.
Yeah.
You know, or a size 22.
Certainly. Yeah. So the power of this, the difference and the power of having a whole bunch of stuff integrated is having your people in one place. When you have multiple systems, and let's say you have an SMS system, you have an email marketing system, you have something else, your CRM system, and you have them all talking to each other, every time you do something, you've got to re-import those contacts, and there's manual processes to doing that. Yes, as you start getting more integrated stuff, that starts to alleviate that, but for like a middle-tier product, this is great from a perspective that you can do the SMSs, your subscription forms, your sign-up forms for events and stuff like that. You can even do payments and that type of thing in here, so you can actually have people buying products through forms, so it's order form products that you're selling, all of that all in one place, and you can be instantly, automatically recording data. Any other questions?
I want to ask if are you keeping all your contacts in this program?
Yes.
Okay, and is it integrated with Gmail at all? If you have contacts in Gmail, can you pull them through?
Yes.
And you can use them from Gmail as well?
Exactly.
Okay, so you wouldn't be using this, you'd only be using this for work-related or promotion-type
That's right.
emails.
That's right. So part of my process is that if I communicate with anyone who comes directly to my email, I literally forward that email to my admin, and I tell them please add this to please add this contact to my database. So that is just part of my policy. Every time anyone new that I get a contact from, I may have met them one on one, and that's business card stuff and all that type of thing. I'm just forwarding that information to my admin to add it to here, so that this becomes my central place that I do all my communication through.
So, for instance, I have like a group of people that I would email, but I mean, it's not income generating. It would just be a separate group. But some of that might be of interest to them. So I could use it either way through Gmail.
Exactly right. Yeah. So if I were to look at just like my groups here, you'll notice there's everything from my social groups to John and Roz group. So, you know, these are ones which are people that we connect with, and Roz used to connect with in Perth when she was there. So, you know, my LinkedIn group, for some reason I may pull them out now. So all my different lists of people from different organizations that I work with. So, you know, the people that I've referred to versus pay people, all sorts of things, you know, subscribers and stuff like that. Different things, you know, work that I've done with Tyler, for instance, and his webinars, and marketed to people on my database, and so anything that I've done, pretty much my number one thing is to record how they interacted then with me, and sometimes it's wide marketing, which is a high level invite, but the whole reason for wide marketing is to understand more about them. But pretty much. There's not one contact in my database that is not connected into a group.
And you're paying for a user license, not per email that goes out, not per transaction, unless it's SMS based.
That's right.
Well, for a user license.
Yeah. So depending on the level of no, this one's not user license. This is actually on activity. So based on how many emails. So you know, you could. For instance, for $30, you can send it out to a list of, I think, 2,000 people each month. So if you have a few hundred people on your database, you could send them out a number of different messages each month within the $30. Once the SMS on top of that, then that just does that separately. Versus the Infusionsoft, which is very much user-based. Philip. Talking stick.
So how does this fit in with your use of Infusionsoft?
Well, I've now migrated. Yeah. So I still have, I have my 41,000 people sitting in here that I have for, I keep this on right now for historical purposes. So I and also for some basic stuff that if I can't do something in Infusionsoft, I can do it in here, just to kind of fill a gap. So at the moment, I keep that on. This has been my tool for the last, really the last 10 years. And now I've just converted to Infusionsoft in the last year. Mm. But you can see why I stayed with this for as long as I did. But it does, yeah. Well, I know it. Yeah, I know it intimately, but it actually does so much, which I couldn't get from a constant contact or a Weber, and it became so hard for me with all those external tools to actually get it all centralized in one place and just have the triggering happening, because I can trigger off the back of this SMSs and emails and stuff like that based on people's interaction to a certain level, all based on timing.
Day, like even 5 years ago, to have it all in this area.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. And of course, you're looking at like a price point, which is, for people who are coming in the entry level, $30, $50, $100, it's a great gap product, where Infusionsoft and those products, as you start going up, they start becoming a real serious business tool, and they carry a price point on that as well. So let's have a look at the next level up, which is an Infusionsoft, and you'll see very quickly why. When I saw what Infusionsoft had, why I took the leap of faith and migrated over, and I'd been watching a number of these systems over time, because when we developed our one. Yeah, a lot of these weren't even around when we developed our one, but as they started coming out, I was looking at the best of what was available and looking at what we could integrate. Infusionsoft built in the ability to take something like what we worked on today, which was a process of putting a marketing campaign together and building it in a very visual way. And the moment they did that, which was about this time last year, when they came out of it, maybe a little bit earlier, but March of last year, they came out with this visual builder, which allowed us to do all of that. So I'm not going to go through too much of Infusionsoft, because from a perspective that everything that I'm just showing you in Platform Direct has all of that plus a whole bunch more. The part that I do is this thing called a campaign builder. So I'm just going to quickly build a campaign and show you and build it with me. So we'll build that webinar campaign and the one that we just did on this board here, and show you how quick and easy you can do that just in one space. Okay, so first of all, what you want to do with any campaign, you want to talk about where are the sources of the traffic going to come from. So if you're going to be going out and doing a webinar, and you're going to be doing it on PPC, you'll probably be talking to people outside of your database. So you might actually be marketing through Facebook and stuff like that, yeah? So let's get a Facebook, let's put Facebook up here and say, yeah, we're going to get some of our market to come from Facebook. We may actually have some of them coming from our existing list, because we'd invite them as well. We might have some of them coming from YouTube, because we may have done a video on it and published that video. And you may have it on from a blog or Twitter and whatever else. You get a sense of that. Yeah. So you put down all of your sources of traffic that are going to come in. At the moment, that's really just for your own reference from a planning perspective. Then what you're going to do is, what's going to happen is you're going to be sending out an email. So I'm actually going to do that here now. I'll actually just set up a sequence that is going to be an email Actually, I want to do that. I'm going to do this quickly here. So, I'll make it simpler. So, we're going to send out an email that's going to go out from our system, and then that's going to be the email invite, and then we're going to invite them to register for the event. So we're going to put a little sign up here. Sign up for webinar. And we're going to just say, well, that's what's going to happen. Other people are going to see an advert on Facebook. They're going to be on my existing list. I'm going to email out, or they're going to see a YouTube video, and then they're going to go over here and they're going to sign up on a form. Yep. And then once that form is completed, we're going to go and go, okay, cool. They're going to put them into a sequence. And what's going to happen in the sequence? What we're going to do, we're going to thank them for signing up. Yeah. So we've got a sequence over here, which is thank you for signing up. And we'll just do that really simply. So this is, we're now inside of that sequence, and we might want to put a delay before we start them up. What's happening? Where is that? Here it is. Let's get that onto the page. So this is the little start of the sequence. We might have a little bit of a delay before we send that. Or we might just send them the email straight away. So what is that delay? The delay might be 15 minutes, or I think that's pretty as little as you can do it. Run at any time, between certain times or whatever else. So you can actually say, well, if it's on a weekend that they signed up, then let's send them the email confirmation on the Monday or whatever it might be. So we've got a little delay timer, and then we're going to send them an email that is confirmation, and then what we're going to do is invite them to share challenges. So that's going to be our email. Yep. Simple enough. Yep. So then they're going to interact with that. So there's going to be a link in there that has them interact, and they're going to then fill in a form. So let's go back to the campaign here. So then they're going to fill in a form, and I'm going to use it as register for an event. But it's essentially what they're going to do is, this is just a form, which is fill in challenges form. So we're going to do that. And then what's going to happen after that? They're going to fill it in. So we've got a sequence here that says, so once they've filled in that form that says, that's a communication, it's an email, and it says, thank you, and then click to confirm participation. Yep. So then there's going to be a link inside there that then checks to see we can probably use anyone there, isn't that right? A link is clicked. Clicks a link. So they're gonna click a link to confirm they're coming. And then we're going to send out a sequence. You guys getting the sense of this?
Yes.
How simple it is? And we're going to put out a sequence, and we're going to do that. And then we're going to have them confirm that they're coming and all that type of thing. So we'll just quickly build it at a very high level, which is, this one here is, this one here is so we go to say thank you, and then they're going to show up at the event. So this one here, they actually physically attended an event. Yep. So I now have a sequence that I have a whole bunch of different things happening in that will run pretty much without me, based on their interaction with it. Yes, there's a whole bunch of things to do still. We've got to write the emails, we've got to actually create the forms, that's all we get. But at a very high level, we've actually planned that out. And of course, we can then at this stage say, well, what if they don't? What if they didn't fill in the form? And what if they didn't attend the event and that type of thing? And I'll show you just on one simple piece over here is attended an event, this one over here. Let's say we're going to have a sequence here which says they didn't attend, and a sequence here that says they did. So based on whichever one that was, so I'm going to pull that out to those two different ones, and you'll see a little thing that pops up over here, which is a decision diamond that says, didn't attend, attended. So over here, let's go over here. So, yeah, exactly. So let's say they showed up for the webinar, so I've actually set this thing over here that says showed up. And let's say they didn't show up. So that's, I think that's right. So depending on which one it is, I'm going to either send them to the didn't attend, or I'm going to send them to the attend. So the rule is, if the contact, and this is just a mechanism called tagging, which basically is just recording what they did or what they didn't do, very simply, contains the webinar showed up. Then go to, didn't want to show up. Doesn't contain. Showed up. And then the second rule is, so if it doesn't contain that, then go to didn't attend. Or if it does contain it, and send it to attended. That makes sense? Very, very simple logic.
Pretty helpful, eh?
Yeah. Yeah, well, I guess if you're looking to automate anything in your business, it doesn't matter the size of the audience. If you can set up a campaign, or when you set up a campaign in this way, it becomes a process. It's an automated process that you don't have to consider showing up every time something happens. You've got to check to see what happened, and then I look at the data and go, okay, so what do I send these people? What do I send that? Where this here, when I run another webinar, I just duplicate this, and I just set up a few other well, I changed some of the language and whatever else, changed the name of the webinar or whatever else, or if it's the same webinar, because I can record the webinar and run it as an automated live webinar, then this can just keep running constantly whilst my Facebook ads are running without me. So that gives you a way of doing that. And then in every sign of that, in every each one of these, if you want to then do the work or if you want to then send your team to go do that, you've actually set that all up and you can give them some direction on what they now need to do at the detail level. So I'm going to actually look at the sign up for webinar form, and actually I can then set that form up so they can go in there and do that. Now I can do that all myself, or I can have my outsourced team do that, and I prefer to have my outsourced team do that, because the more that I do it means the less that I'm actually working on my business and I'm working in it. I don't make money from sitting here doing this work. I make money from actually working out on the promotion and actually getting the promotion right and finding the partners who are going to promote with me. So for instance, over here, I want a checkbox that's going to essentially be, yes, I'm going to show up. Checkbox label is sign me up for the webinar, whatever it is, and I pre-check it on. So it could be as simple as that. That's their sign-up form. They come in there. The system itself will pre-populate their first name and email. It's already ticked sign me up for the webinar, and they hit submit. So my form's done now, thank you. I can now go back. You can write a little thank you page if you like on that, but really very simple stuff. And already I'm creating the campaign for this webinar.
So within Infusionsoft too, you can actually manage multiple businesses, can't you? Like,
yeah.
For a marketing specialist like yourselves, then, mm-hmm. I mean, that's a primary tool to be able to just put all your contacts and run different businesses all in the one system.
Yes and no. And Philip will give you some feedback as well. You can run multiple businesses that are associated closely, certainly from a perspective of your design criteria, when it comes to, you know, specific address details and stuff like that, that sits at the bottom of your emails and that type of thing. Infusionsoft only allows you to have one set of that kind of template in there. You can have different email templates that you can then set up inside of these campaigns that send it out. But there's specific information about your business which is specific to you that has to be in part of every single communication that goes out. So as long as they are related in a way that they come back and you're happy with the, you know, even if it's as simple as the address that's at the bottom of your emails that Infusionsoft will put in there for you, then, you know, that's probably a criteria that you need to address or consider if you're running multiple businesses. But otherwise, yeah. Yeah, I out of this one here, I run, as you can see, different businesses, but essentially all of them come back to me as John Abbott, as Results Platform Foundation, as the umbrella. Yeah. But different, I guess, different brands under that umbrella, different products. Do you want to add to that, Philip?
Yeah, but it's definitely designed for one business. Heard a question at a forum the other day. It gets really, really messy if you have multiple things. But John is positioning himself as a brand. So you, John Abbott, is the brand. Mm. And you've got all these sub things, and that fits in with your business. But that's quite unusual. So it's definitely designed for one business. Like if you have one registered address, all your common branding, logos, all that sort of stuff. Mm. So I've heard it can get really tricky if you're trying to be seen as like three different businesses with inside one account.
Mm.
You really should be getting three accounts. So that's how it's designed. But there could be workarounds. But I've heard it gets very, very messy.
Yeah. Anywhere from about $200 a month, I think it's $200 odd, I think $259. They've just done a cost structure shift at the moment, so $259 entry level. Yep.
I'll refer you. They've got amazing kickbacks. I was going to say I went to the conference in Phoenix a couple of months ago, and I bought the videos and all that stuff. So if anybody wants to watch any of the sessions. There was something like six tracks on at any point in time for 3 days. So there's some really good case studies of businesses that are doing it really well, just standing up talking about how to change their business.
Yeah.
And I mean, So if you sign with me. So I go to a lot of conferences and stuff, and this conference actually blew my mind in terms of the excitement around all the users, because I'm just really starting this. And there was 2,200 businesses there all just going, VisionSoft. And amazing case studies as well. So you're welcome to get my login.
Yeah. Well, what we might do, Philip, if you are clearly okay with that, is we'll actually set that up on various evenings, set up a computer, log it on, and actually just play some of those videos. Yeah, that'll be great. On.
So I have a friend that's very successful with HubSpot. I just want to know if anyone knows the difference. Phil, do you know?
Go over.
Oh, John? Yeah.
My understanding is HubSpot's actually for the next size of business up from Infusionsoft, generally speaking. I know there's a lot of small operators using HubSpot. HubSpot is an all-in-one marketing solution, right? So you actually... Infusionsoft will work with a WordPress website or any different type of website, any different type of Google Analytics product, so you can be on all sorts of different software, and Infusionsoft is the back end. Right. HubSpot gets rid of all that.
Yep.
So for some people, they see it as very easy, and HubSpot are just going gangbusters, like everyone's talking about them. They have geniuses at content marketing.
Yes.
So basically, the nice thing about HubSpot is that's the only system you'll ever need. But then you're locked in with them, and you're on their platform, you can't go anywhere else. Really good at, you know, if you want to post blogs, look at your analytics, you want to do e-commerce, all those little things of online marketing, HubSpot will be able to do for you. I can't remember the pricing off the top of my head, not that cheap, but essentially, if you work the system well, the value you're going to get from it is going to be massive. But it sounds like they're at the next level up. So in my mind, Office Autopilot and Fusionsoft are for sort of 1 to 20 staff members. And probably the next level up from 20 upwards is HubSpot as a general rule, but I know there's lots of small businesses using HubSpot as well. If you go to their website, you'll see incredible case studies of how businesses have just gone through the roof using the system.
Right.
So the primary thing there is that where you can build all of your direct communication from perspective of marketing, promotion, and connection with your clients, in Infusionsoft, and then selling them a product through the shop. What HubSpot does is then give you, well, what is the website that is your brand? You know, how do you communicate on the website at a web level with them on a day-to-day basis? What are the results and tie that back in really effortlessly? You know, what's your search engine optimization stuff that you're building inside of that? So it's very specifically around how do you automate all aspects of your online business all in one place, rather than Infusionsoft, where they've got a number of different things that they've gone in one place, but then they go, well, what we're going to do now is open up our architecture so that you can then use all these other applications best of breed in these different areas and utilize them to actually feed that information back into Infusionsoft. I'm neither here nor there against one versus the other one. I see HubSpot when I look at forums and stuff like that. I see HubSpot still working. You know, when they look at comparisons, they're still comparing themselves against Office Autopilot and Infusionsoft. So they see them as competitors as well. They might be looking to reposition themselves as a higher one, but at the moment when I saw their stuff, I saw very much a they're playing in a very similar market because they obviously have a lot of similar people that would use that. But it's about total integration in one place versus integration of, I guess, your core elements in one place and then total open architecture to communicate with others.
And can you run multiple businesses in HubSpot?
Don't know that level of detail. Yeah.
I think SMS in Infusionsoft as well is an add-on.
Yep.
Isn't it?
Yeah, that's right. So that's the open architecture stuff. For instance, I utilize an add-on which is called Stealth Webinar. So any webinars and stuff that I run, I automate those webinars. So turn a project and a promotion into a process, So my promotion is, let's say this is the webinar that I'm going to be talking to people about. I then record that with all of the interaction on the webinar with everybody, and I then put that into Stealth Webinar, which then invites people as if it's a live event. So, you know, I can do marketing out into communities, into Facebook and whatever else, and invite people into a webinar with me, but I'm actually not showing up again. And I can then set the criteria of when those will run, what time, and people get the same experience as if it was a live event. So the system looks the same as when you register for a certain date. The way that I presented the event is very, very much around, you know, leaving, you know, being very conscious on what I'm saying, so that I'm not talking about it being morning here or evening, or it's this day or that day, unless of course I'm going to run it on a specific morning every week or something like that. So you can start automating and putting things into process once you start considering that everything you do is an opportunity for you to record and then play out again. And you can do that as recordings, but when people think they're in live or feel like they're part of a live event, there's a different level of attention that happens when, if you watch a recorded webinar versus the real live thing, how much more attention do you give it? Yeah, because you feel that you're all part of that. So it's been very, very smart that the way that they've done something like that. So Stealth Webinar is one of them. There's Evergreen that has a similar product that works well, and that's all integrated into Infusionsoft. So I know who's signed up, who showed up, and I even know how much or how far they actually watched the webinar. So if they've watched, my criteria did they watch the first quarter, first half, three quarters, and if they watch the first quarter, they haven't got enough. If they've watched half, they've got probably enough to be dangerous. And if they watch three quarters, then they've actually seen pretty much everything that I needed to convey in that. So I can be having that, so my communication then is different to the people who actually watch for different lengths. That concludes our session for today. Has that been helpful? Excellent. Yes. Talking stick.
Woohoo! Just, Casey was saying that he needs to learn this kind of stuff, but for him it's like, ugh, you know.
Yeah.
And then I just wanted to tell him that I've worked on two content management systems for other businesses. That's one, you know, as a freelancer. So if you need this stuff but you don't want to do it yourself, it's not something that you actually have to do. It's quite easy to outsource. There's lots of people that will do this for you.
Yep.
You can like buy the system or buy your license and then get another company to send out your stuff for you. And then if you want to do it yourself, you can. It's easy enough. But if you find it boring or too time consuming, you don't have to.
The easiest thing is to actually set a promotion. So set up something that you'd love to communicate to others. Don't worry about how you're going to get the people just yet. You know, you can utilize all sorts of ways of doing that. But set up a concept of what kind of promotion you'd like to put out, and you know what kind of people you'd like to attract, and what you'd like, you know, what kind of content you'd like to deliver in that, and then have an outcome of it. Have people subscribe to your YouTube channel or whatever it might be. It might just be a very simple way of, you know, getting your brand out there, or getting, you know, your message out there to get started. Yeah, and then find one of the programs and actually play with it, because then at least you have a purpose for playing with it, rather than just like, yeah, I'm going to just play around and I'm going to add some context and I'm going to learn it. Actually set it up by putting a project in place, and then you'll learn it much quicker. Cool. All right. That concludes today. What I'd love you to do, you have all got the yellow post-it notes. So I encourage you to take those post-it notes today and work out one or two things or both. One is how you could some of the ways of automating yourself. So putting in, utilizing the example that Sandra did and talking about all the tasks that you do every day and actually start documenting that, because at some stage you're going to have people that will replace you if that's name of yours. So look at doing that. And then utilize the same technique and actually build your event. So actually build, like you, Philip, if you're going to do a webinar, you know, let's do a webinar while you're here in iLab. Let us all get on that webinar and we'll learn from you as well, and we'll give you feedback. And I encourage everyone to do that. all, you know, if you want to run a webinar, there's a safe environment. You know, there's a safety net here for you to run that in. Share the content that you want to share, and we can also then give you feedback on the presentation and the offer and all that type of thing that you put out there. And of course, you can invite other people as well, so that you know, you have some of your network that's part of that as well, if you're confident in doing that, as I'm sure you would be, Casey. So I'd love you to do that. I would take a door with two frames and create that as yours. So take some ownership of that, and you can stick your sticky notes up on the glass and start building that, and that's going to start helping you automate and systemize your business. Excellent. All right.
Thanks.
We will see you tomorrow. Today was Systems Day. Yeah, exactly. Fantastic. Give yourselves a round of applause for being here today. Well done. And for making it through without falling asleep. Thanks, Shane.